Tell me about your trip. You had a bit of an adventure getting here. Tell me what happened.
Oh my God, I'm telling you now. We were stuck on this flight, I think. Basically, some lady was saying that, like, oh, if anything should happen on the, like, I'm just saying, like, if I've ever upset you and text messaging someone, and somebody interpreted that, rudely reading it over her shoulder, and automatically decided she was a terrorist. Yeah, and they got off the plane, that refused to fly, and then, literally, the poor girl got chucked off the plane as well.
Whereabouts did you get chucked off the plane?
This was at Gatwick, so we had to do a full circle of the runway, yeah. Come back in, get their luggage off, have the full plane checked, and then take off again. So we missed our connecting flight, got stranded in Istanbul. Not the one.
Not what you want
on fight week.
Yeah.
Not the one on fight week. Wouldn't be so bad on a family holiday, but.
What happened in Istanbul?
Nothing really. Nearly got chucked out the airport a couple of times, just being me, innit? But other than that.
So did you just stay in the airport when you were in Istanbul, though?
Just stay in the airport.
Waiting for your connecting flight.
Yeah, just waiting for my. Went and got a hotel, got my head down, behaved myself.
Yeah. And then when did you arrive here?
I arrived here about 3 o'clock yesterday morning.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
So not ideal for you?
No, not ideal. Not ideal, but we're here now and we're just, I'm soaking it up. Very happy to be part of this show. So all I've got to do now is go and bring the win home that I've worked hard for back in the home of Hatfield, Hertfordshire. So
tell me about how the opportunity arose for you to fight on this card.
Basically, I was meant to fight Majidov on the Monte Carlo show, and then Eddie just came up to me and said, listen, I think we're going to put you on the Saudi bill. I was like, yeah, let's have it.
Were you excited when he told you
that?
Yeah,
of course. Listen, there's something very special about this show in general. I think it stands out to be one of the best, one of the biggest shows of the decade. So, yeah, it's got, like, something special about it, like that Rumble in the Jungle feel, do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
So we're gonna see if Joshua's cut from the Lennox Lewis cloth,
yeah,
or the Muhammad Ali cloth. Well, if he does win it back, he's done one more than them, because what he's achieved his greatness in 10 years of boxing from scratch.
Yeah.
So if he does that and regains the title all in that short amount of time, he's obviously one up them. But is he cut from that cloth, or is he a Buster Douglas? So
what do you think of the fight? A lot of people think he's going to box at range. I'm not so sure if that's the best option for him, whether he can last the 12, you know, if he's got the engine to do it, especially if Ruiz is attacking the body. What do you think? How would you approach it if you were Joshua?
Listen, the way I'd fight him is the way I'd fight any small man. The minute they get past my wrist, I'll take the extra step towards them, lock their arms up, I'll win ugly. Jab and grab, Klitschko. The Klitschko blueprint,
yeah,
is the way forward for a smaller man. It ain't pretty. It's not going to be the best Storm, Salah and everything like that. But win by an inch is better than losing by a mark.
And do you think he's going to do it?
Yeah, I do. I look to see him slow Ruiz down and catch him late on.
What about your fight? You're fighting Majidov, amateur standout. Have you seen many of his fights? His amateur
do you know
fights?
What? I've not even watched him. I've literally just left that down to my coach, Josh Burnham. And I've let him do the homework. All I'm going to do is win 3 minutes at a time every round. 3 minutes at a time, do whatever I've got to do to win that round, come back, box to orders, that's it. If I catch him, I'll catch him. He looks like he'll mark up a bit, so we'll see.
What are you expecting from him? What are you expecting him to bring?
I think pretty much what he looks like, really, just a rough man. Like he looks like, not just saying it, he looks a bit like a serial killer. So I'm not expecting like a namby-pamby, tippy-tappy fight. I think he's going to try and make it as physical as possible. It's my job to nullify that with my attributes, and we've worked diligently on it. So I'm excited. I just can't wait to get in there. I've had two back-to-back camps. I just want to fight now. Do you know what I mean? I just want to fight.
Yeah. Hungry man.
Hungry.
Tell me about your experience in Saudi Arabia so far. I know you've not been here long, but were you surprised? Was it what you expected? Was it different?
Do you know what? Listen, everything has been complete. You hear a lot of horror stories and everyone that said, oh, be careful. Oh, like...
Yeah.
This place has actually been, like, the most beautiful, warm, welcoming. And I'm a notorious tow rack. Like, I'm the person who can't walk out the door without offending someone.
Yeah.
And everything has been like, people can't do enough for you. It's really, 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 really good. I like.
So please, to give us some big,
I think this could be a new Vegas.
A new place for boxing.
Yeah, a new big place for the big stars of boxing, definitely.
Let's hope so. It's been a pleasure speaking to you, Tom, and all the best in your fight, my friend.
Bless you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, mate.